So today's video is going to be on the subject of actual versus market growth. And I'm going to be talking a little bit about what a market bubble is and what typically will happen with a bubble. And so, just to start with the difference between what actual growth is and what market growth is, I have to talk a little bit about, I'll use an analogy to explain it. So let's say that you have a company that mines gold and then sells that gold. And they have only one mine, and what their actual value would be, let's say that they get an accurate estimate of how much is in that mine, and let's say it's $100 million. Well, the actual value of that mining company would be $100 million less any of the costs associated with getting the gold out of the ground and producing it. So, in the realm of $100 million less costs, that's what the actual value of that company is. Now, what market value and market growth is, let's say you have that same company with that same gold mine worth $100 million. Now, what happens is people think that gold prices are going to go up in the near future. What happens is the value of that company when it comes to market growth will go up. People are speculating that prices are going to go up for oil, for gold rather, and so they decide this company's worth more because in the future there's a likelihood that they'll be able to sell their gold for more. And so the market growth increases for that company. And this is natural, and this is actually an important part of investing because investors look for companies that are undervalued, overvalued, based on different things going on in the world, different things that they think are going to happen. And it is actually a relatively commonplace sort of part of investing and of the economy. But there's an issue, and that's when something, what's known as a bubble, happens. So what I'm going to do is draw a graph, and what we're going to have is, this is, say, the actual growth of the economy over time. So the economy is gradually growing. That is what the actual growth is. So as companies expand, they're opening new stores, they're producing more stuff. That is that actual growth. Now what happens with a market bubble is, typically you're going to see sort of similar patterns with market growth to actual growth. And what happens with a bubble is over time, for whatever reason, prices really start to go up comparatively to the actual market. This can be for a number of different reasons. And the issue with this, though, is this difference, the bubble, it doesn't actually exist. There's no actual growth there. It's sort of a hypothetical growth. And eventually, with bubbles, when it becomes sort of an unrealistic valuation of market growth, of market value, the bubble will pop. And that's when you typically see crashes, where it comes back down to reality, where it comes back down to the actual growth, or even goes further down below. That's when you see things like the 2001 dot-com crash. What happened was, that was sort of when the internet was first really starting to take off. People were buying the domains for various things, and they would basically start a company around that domain, and then they could sell shares on the stock market for it. And it was crazy. Prices were rising incredibly fast, and they rapidly outpaced the actual value of what was in the economy. Those companies, those shares of those companies, were getting crazy valuations, and ultimately it's unsustainable because there's no actual real growth associated with it. And what happens with bubbles, it's very rare that you see a gradual return to realistic prices, because what happens is people see this growth here and they decide, wow, I want to invest because you can make so much money. Prices are increasing rapidly. And what happens is over time, it continues going until the bubble pops for whatever reason. And then people realize, oh God, this is not worth what I thought it was. And it comes crashing down. And that's when you see these dramatic crashes when it comes to 2001, when it comes to 2008, when mortgage sort of real estate prices were incredibly high, and bubbles are very dangerous and they need to be hopefully avoided as much as possible. And why this is sort of relevant to today's discussion is there are considerable likelihood of there being a number of different market bubbles in the world right now when it comes to real estate, when it comes to tech stock. Tech stock is actually very hard to evaluate when it comes to actual growth, because when you think of a company like Facebook, obviously you can say, okay, they make X amount of dollars each year, so they must be worth this much. But then you also have to factor in how much is their brand worth? How much is the fact that they're so dominant in their market worth? That obviously has to have value associated with it, because a company like Twitter, for a number of years, has not made money, but they still trade at hundreds of millions of dollars in their total value. And you see bubbles pop up in these areas, and they're very dangerous because they ultimately will typically result in these crashes, and they should be avoided as much as possible. And sort of the best way to sort of avoid this is, as with many things in investing, is always to diversify, have your money spread out across a number of different areas, and you'll protect yourself from these sort of gaps between actual versus market growth. Hopefully that sort of explained a little bit about the difference between the two and what issues can arise when they start to separate and have a gap, the bubble between them. And as always, if you like the content, please feel free to like, share, and subscribe. Helps me grow as a channel.